I believe that many people still think that this cable here is just for internet, because for quite some time, people just plug it into a laptop in order to get a stable internet connection. But actually, once you set things up properly and get the right devices, you can transfer data through this cable up to the speed of 10 gigabit per second. And if you convert that into gigabyte per second and subtract for some overhead, the real world speed come out as around 1.1 to 1.2 gigabyte per second. And I couldn't even believe in my eyes that it was that fast. The data was transferred through this Cat6 cable, not just any regular USB cable. And with this kind of speed, it was faster than many SSD boxes that we currently have here. We can access them instantly, we can copy files very quickly, and even editing videos from multiple devices directly from this NAS. So in this video on the 10 gig NAS, I will give you an overview. What is a 10 gigabit network NAS? Why did we decide to build one? What kind of equipment do you need to build your own NAS? And we will do a demo to see how this system performs. Now, let's get started. So what is a NAS and what is it used for? I won't give you another lecture on this NAS thing, because that kind of stuff is all over the internet. You can look it up very easily. But in simple term, NAS is a massive data storage. So why is it different? So the great thing about NAS is that you can access this giant data storage in many different ways, either wire or wireless, and both work great. So here at ThingVue, we are using the Synology NAS, the DS1522+, and inside we got 18 terabyte of hard drive installed, which costs us more than $1,000. From this NAS, we can connect it to our Mac Studio and a PC via a 10 gig network, and we could achieve the transfer speed up to 1 gigabyte per second. And in case of a 2.5 gig network, we've hooked it up to this ITX PC and seeing the real world speed around 300 megabyte per second. You can also use a 1 gigabit connection, but we're not using it in our studio anymore, because the wire 1 gig network isn't faster than our Wi-Fi here. So in case of the 1 gigabit network, we would rather let our laptop and smartphone in the studio connect wirelessly to the NAS to access the file. And when we are away from the studio, we can still access file from the NAS using Synology Drive, just like Google Drive. But the great thing is that the file are now stored locally on your own NAS at the studio. So why do we need a 10 gig NAS? I think that after that storyboard, you'll probably get why do we need it. But to explain a little bit more, we will using our real need a ThingVue for a clearer demonstration. You see, we have always edited videos on these little SSD boxes. Well, the great thing is that now we get a lot of storage, but the downside is that the data gets scattered and fragmented, and the footage is all over the places. And time from time, the cable will getting messy. And another thing is that they only hold up to 1 or 2 terabyte of data each, which is too little space. And usually, with our current workflow, a project could get up to 300 to 500 gigabyte each. So what if you need more storage? 1 gigabit NAS would be the most common solution, but it's not fast enough to edit high bitrate videos. So what if you need both large storage and the ability to directly editing? Well, come to NAS. It's like a giant SSD boxes that connect to your PC via Thunderbolt or USB. So if your workflow related to multiple user, that's a no-go. And another thing is that it cannot be accessed from afar like Google Drive. So if you want multi people to access and editing file at the same time, a 2.5 gig or 10 gig NAS is the way to go. With 2.5 gig network, we got the real speed up to around 300 megabytes per second. Well, it's fairly good if we are editing TikTok videos that got shot from this Lumix S5. But for YouTube videos, usually that will be recorded by this Blackmagic. And each ARRW file alone can store up to 200 gigabytes. And the whole project could be around somewhere 400 gigabytes each. That's a ton of storage. So at ThingView, we store all of our project files on the NAS. And after recording, we dumped all the footage here. Once editing is finished, the editor keeps the whole project and no need to delete it like before. All the effect and transition are already there, and all they need to do is just tweaking the text or reorder thing a bit more for future project. Another example here is that once we finishing editing and rendering the videos, the final videos will be on the NAS. And then we just need to generate a link and then send them to our partner. That's all. We don't have to re-upload it again and then have to wait for a few hours like before with our Google Drive workflow. And that's just the two scenarios. There are a lot of benefits using the 10 gig NAS, especially if your workflow related to a large shared storage that require a high-speed multi-user access. So how to set up a 10 gig NAS? Well, to set up a 10 gig NAS, firstly, you have to have a NAS that supports 10 gig Ethernet. And for example, the Synology Drive DS1522 Plus we have here has an expansion slot. And then we use the EU10G22T1 mini network card, which costs around $100. Then all you need to do is plug in the Cat6 cable from the NAS to the TP-Link 10 gig switch. This switch over here has the role to manage the data flow and prevent the data congestion. And from there, you run the cable to your other devices. With this Mac Studio, it's fairly easy because it already has a built-in 10 gig LAN port. It's just plug and play. And for the PC that don't have the 10 gigabit Ethernet pre-installed, well, I suggest that you should buy a PCIe 10 gig network card, which would cost about a few hundred US dollar for a quality one. Then plug it into your motherboard, connect the cable, and you're good to go. And in case of our ITX PC, the XI60i gaming Wi-Fi motherboard already support for 2.5 gigs. So no need to buy anything extra. Just plug in the cable and enjoy up to 300 megabytes per second. And finally, you will need one cable to go from your switch to the router. This should give your Synology Drive the internet access in order to use such function like remote access via Synology Drive. And this also give the internet access to all devices in your studio via the LAN port. Like our ThinkPad X1 Carbon Gen 12 here is mapped to the NAS via the studio Wi-Fi. So how do you get the best speed? Well, talking about the speed, we can benchmark the speed using Crystal Dismark and get a result about 1 gigabyte per second for both write and read speed. It means that it will get around the same speed as those 10 gigabit SSD boxes that you would get on the market. And to get that kind of speed, you need to make sure to use this kind of setup. First, we have to install 5 Synology hard drives inside the NAS. Each has a theoretical speed of around 243 megabytes per second. We then set them up in RAID 0, which merged them into a single 18 terabyte drive with 5 times the speed. And this alone can get us up to 1 gigabyte per second in terms of speed. But to ensure a stable speed, you need to use a pair of SSD as cache, because SSD are faster, and the Synology caching mechanism store frequent access file like active video project on the SSD. So opening or dragging and dropping file is super fast. Of course, we know that using RAID 0 here is super risky, Because just one drive fail, you will lose every data on this NAS. So we're just using it as a demo. But for important file, we always ought to back it up into Google Drive. And for even more secure setup, Synology do offer other RAID type to match your needs. So, should you buy a Synology NAS or build your own? Many people wonder whether to buy a Synology NAS or to build their own NAS from an old PC to save money. For example, the DS1522 Plus here costs around $800 US, and that is excluding any hard drive or SSD cache. It's not even included the 10GB card. And at the same time, DIY your own NAS from an old PC may cost you just around $200 US. That's about 1/4 of the price. So DIY NAS is a good choice for those who like to tinker and learn. However, Synology NAS system has some clear strength, as it has a compact design, it is more energy efficient, quieter operation, and official warranty. And in my opinion, the most important thing is that the intuitive user interface, because Synology NAS runs its own operating system like a standalone computer. It supports for Synology Drive and Synology Photos for you to work from afar, and especially thanks to these equipment that help us through some big event like the Computex or even the Apple WWDC when we are on the field and our editor at home still got all the footage that we sent back home. And of course, vice versa, if our cameraman at the studio has some footage at the studio, he can send that to our editor that works from afar. And of course, for the file to automatically sync like that, you will do some setup in the app setting. There are two options. It's free up space where the file remains on the NAS and you have to manually download it when you need it, and pin the local copy where the file stays synced between the NAS and your local devices all the time. If you added or deleted something on one, it updates to another. In our case, since we always want to immediately access to our footage, we use pin local copy. But for folder like photos or other non-essential copy, we use free up space to save local storage and only downloading thing when we need them. And for Synology Photos, it syncs both your images and videos, just like Google Photos. For example, whenever I do the camera test on different phones, I go to the outside and take a bunch of photos. As soon as I'm done testing, those photos automatically sync through the Synology Photos app on my phone and then it gets uploaded to the NAS. Synology software is honestly super easy to use. When I tested it with my iPhone, it's created a folder called iPhone and tagged it with a timestamp. So if I log in with the same account on an Oppo Find N5, the system automatically created a separate folder called Oppo Find N5 and they will be synced. And this will make us easier to evaluate and comparing each of them to see which is better. So basically, that's most of our experience with this whole NAS thing setup. What would you benefit from the same setup? Let me know in the comment section, okay? And don't forget to hit the subscribe button so you won't miss any upcoming videos about the latest tech and accessories. Now, thanks for watching. This is NK from ThinkView and see you guys next time.